Hello everybody and welcome to today's video. My name is Rebecca Ravenbird and today I am going to be showing you the footage that I captured from my club's most recent event, celebrating 9 months of membership as well as St. Patrick's Day, and this event was called Pot of Gold. So this was an event that me and one of my club leaders came up with. It's basically a hide and seek event. The idea of the event was that a few people who volunteered would dress up in all yellow and ride a Palomino horse, and they would hide in one of five locations, including Yarl South Hoof, Mistfall, Golden Hills, and Steve/Everwin Fields. And so they would be hiding all over Jorvik, while other people who are dressed up in green, they are leprechauns. So the leprechauns are trying to find a pot of gold. And so we could only claim one pot of gold at a time, and if we found somebody, then we could help the other people try to find another pot of gold. So as you can see in this clip, I am actually coming up with an outfit. I am a leprechaun, even though I am, you know, running the event and trying to moderate it, I was trying to play as well. That way it could just be a little more interesting to have some more eyes trying to look for each of these pots of gold. And so this outfit here was kind of interesting to make. The green hat and the green shirt didn't really match, nor did the green gloves, but it was all for good fun, you know, just dressing up in green and trying to match, you know, all the green items that I had in my inventory. It was a lot of fun, but I was a little bit stressed trying to come up with an outfit here. Alrighty, so in this clip you can see that we are all meeting here at Steve's farm. Our pots of gold are on the left, while the leprechauns, the seekers, are on the right. And so we actually tried to do this event with Ocean Friends, which is our sister club, but they unfortunately, not a lot of them were able to come, but for those who did come, they had a fun time celebrating with us. And so another thing that was interesting about this event was that we actually had to do it in the Say Chat, because Emerald Hunters is familiar now with using voice commands and being on call for events or practices, but Ocean Friends is not. And so we decided it would be most fair if we did it through Say Chat, so everyone could participate. Looking back on this event, I realized it probably wasn't the greatest idea to meet here, considering how many people are here and how many people are interested in looking at this big group of Emerald Hunters, but at the same time, honestly, it is kind of a recruiting tactic. You know, people are very attracted to seeing a lot of people with the same club name, same outfits, or just a big group of people in general. So it was very attractive to a lot of people, and you can see in this clip here that there is a lot of people hovering around and trying to ask us questions about Emerald Hunters and being interested in joining. And so I got very distracted. I probably should have ignored these people just so that we could get the event started. But at the same time too, it is a little bit about club visibility. I think no matter where we would have met, we would have been, you know, having all of these people here watching us and asking us questions about the club and, you know, being interested in joining. So finally, in this clip, I did release the pots of gold. They had 10 minutes to hide, and I did put them in a group, as you can see on the left here, so that they could tell me and figure out where they all wanted to go. They couldn't hide, like, two pots of gold in the same general area, so there had to be at least one pot of gold in each of the different areas. So they all had to sort of coordinate with each other and figure out where they were going to go. In the meantime, while I was here, because the pots of gold had to take some time to hide, I got to explain a little bit about each of the locations where they were all going. So I had to remind them, okay, here were the five locations that we're going to be looking for, and again reiterating the rule about not finding more than one pot of gold. You were only allowed to find one pot of gold at a time. And so I was able to stay here a little bit and also talk to the people who were interested in joining and just kind of, you know, introduce ourselves to them and, you know, tell them how to find our application. So anytime you're interested in joining Emerald Hunters, you will definitely have to take a look down in the description of the video, or you can go to our Instagram page, which is at emeraldhunters.sso, and you can find the link to our application there. I was thinking about creating a separate Emerald Hunters YouTube channel, but I actually have a lot of different Google accounts and it's just a lot to manage. And so I don't know, I think it would be better if I just more clearly tag my videos that include Emerald Hunters, or make a playlist that includes Emerald Hunters. And so yeah, definitely Emerald Hunters is being featured on my channel, but this channel is not specifically just about Emerald Hunters. So again, if you'd like to ever look up Emerald Hunters, you are welcome to do so on my channel, and you also are welcome to look us up on our website, which is also linked down in the description below. The first location that I scouted out in this game was Golden Hills, and I was talking about the entire Golden Hills area. area that they could choose from. So I did not specify, you know, whether they had to be in Golden Hills Valley or Jasper's Farm or anything like that. So, and it was the same for all the other areas too. Like, they didn't have to be specifically at South Hoof Farm. They didn't have to be specifically within Yorvik Stables, that sort of area. And so I let them have a lot of free range because I wanted this game to last for a while. And it was actually kind of interesting. We found them relatively quickly. And I think, you know, it definitely helped that they were wearing yellow so that they would stand out. But they had really good hiding places too at the same time. So the pots of gold did a really nice job of hiding in different areas. And definitely with the Golden Hills area, it was pretty easy to hide in this area, I think, because, you know, there's a lot of literally gold leaves all over the place, so you could just hide in a bush and be done with it. So yeah, as you can see in this clip, I am just going all over the place trying to look in the trees and bushes and things like that, and we had some of them, you know, try to give some hints. And so also throughout this exploration on my part, because again, I was trying to moderate it, you can see me going through the chat and doing reminders about where people are and who's been found and where and how many pots of gold we're looking for next. And so it was really interesting because, like I said, they had a lot of the map to explore and hide with, and they had 10 minutes to hide, so it was, you know, a little bit of time to give them to hide, but also a little bit of a time crunch because, you know, within 10 minutes you have to think of an area and you have to think about how you're going to position yourself so that you can remain hidden, and also the fact that you're not typing in the chat either because we can see our chat bubbles too. So yeah, it was a really cool experience. I went up to like Scarecrow Hill, I went all over the beach area, I went to Cape West Fishing Village. So yeah, I had a lot of fun trying to participate in this event as well. So eventually in this clip, we were able to narrow down where one of our club members was. Her name was Moon. We were able to narrow down that she was at least on the beach area, but the only possible area that I could think of, at least initially, was in the smuggler's cave. And so here I am with Maddie. We're trying to find her and I had no idea where she was. So I figured she maybe was under the dock or something, or maybe she was, I don't know, standing above us somehow. And then eventually I don't know how we figured it out, but we did eventually figure out that she was in a rock. And so it was really cool because I believe what happened was I was hovering my mouse over a rock, and you know that little person icon that shows up when you hover over a person? So that showed up and I was actually able to find her. Now, I don't think it was like cheating or anything because I knew at least she was going to the Golden Hills area, but she did not specify to us in the chat where she was going. So I was able to find her. And so yeah, it was really cool because she was one of the last people to be found. We had Kara Ravenholm, who was in the Jarlaheim area, who still had to be found. So yeah, here she is. I found her in the rock. As you can see, the chat bubble did give her away, and I actually did take a picture for proof to see like, hey, you know, I found her in the rock. So it was a lot of fun finding her. So in this last part of the video here, we are all meeting back at Steve's farm and we are dressing up in rainbow colors because what we were going to do was the traveling rainbow. So the traveling rainbow was just going to be some basic off-rail dressage and we would be dressing up in these colors because of the St. Patrick's Day tradition of a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. So if you ever think of that imagery, that's what we were trying to recreate. And so you can actually see a lot of Pink Queen's Legacy members saying hi to us, and they were really interested in our outfits, particularly the traffic cone outfit that Moon was wearing. I thought it was a great outfit, and it was really nice of Pink Queen's Legacy to say hi to us, and of course we said hi to them as well. They've always been really nice and supportive of, you know, not just Emerald Hunters, but all the clubs that they meet, all the people that they meet, they're always very kind and supportive, and so that really is awesome that they, you know, came out and just said hello to us and had a good time, you know, just hanging out out saying hi to us, looking at our outfits. And so yeah, we actually had a few people that also wanted to join us who were not in our club, but they decided, you know, let's dress up a little bit and sort of travel with the traveling rainbow. And so you'll see me in the say chat trying to command a little bit. It's been a while since I've like commanded in chat, so I was kind of a little bit rusty, and also I had a lot of spelling mistakes just straight up because I had not been chat commanding in a while, so my fingers were a little rusty in that sense. I wasn't too hard on them about gaps or timing or anything, partially because we were all on different horses, different outfits, different stats, and so I said, you know what, let's just try to use one horse gaps and not really worry about it too much. It was just for fun, mostly just for the visual appeal of the colors and trying to do, you know, a little bit of dressage and have fun traveling around doing that. And so yeah, you'll get to see the traveling rainbow coming through Jorvik. Alright everybody, that is going to be the end of today's video vlog. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you would ever like to use these events for your club for the next St. Patrick's Day, or just for any sort of random club event, you are most welcome to do so. It's just, you know, I would like, I guess, some credit, because these ideas and the design and the planning of these events were with me and my club leader. So we are just taking some pics here at the very end, so I had so much fun filming and hanging out with these friends and celebrating 9 months of club membership as well as St. Patrick's Day. So again, thank you so much for watching, and be sure to subscribe to my channel if you'd like to watch more videos like this. With that being said, I will see you all in my next video. Bye!